little bit heavier now.
That is pretty darn good.
Well, hello everyone. As you can see, it is absolutely coming down. I've got the camera set up. This is a new camera, and I've got the rain cover on it because otherwise it would not be surviving right now. It's not too heavy, but it's going to get heavier in the night. Big bloody hike in. Anyway, first things first, I'm going to get the tarp up. Hopefully these tea tree are strong enough to support it. Should be fine. We're not dealing with winds tonight, so I'm going to get that set up now, and then we can keep everything dry underneath. Hello everyone. Man, that was a struggle in the rain. My paracord was all tangled up. It was an absolute nightmare to set that up, but it's done now. We've just got a few more adjustments to make, but yeah, it's got some nice height I can stand up on it, so I'm happy about that. As you would have seen, just set the tent up as well. That rain's still coming down. Just a bit of a heavy drizzle at the moment. I'm going to set up my bedding, so a sleeping bag, air mat. I'll set up my chair and have a rest for 10 minutes, I think. Hello everyone, all set up. This is quite annoying. I'm gonna, once the rain stops, settles, I'll give the tarp a bit of an adjustment. Hopefully I can get rid of this. I've only got limited trees in this spot. I found a really nice clearing. And I'm actually on a farm. I'm on my friend's farm. They've given me permission to stroll around and find areas to film in, so pretty dense bush, but I managed to find this clearing. It's actually quite big, quite a big area. I'll show you soon. Probably like 50 square meters or something. I've got the Nature Hike Monga 2 today. I've got the Bushbuck mat. I've got the Nature Hike sleeping bag, the Snowbird minus 2. I've got my awesome 4x4 tarp. Got my Nature Hike chair, and I've got some delicious dinner to be done on my alcohol stove. It's just gone 5 p.m. Got around 2 hours, hour and a half of light left. And it is set to chuck down in about an hour's time. So I'm glad I got in here and got set up. There's a bit humming and harring with the rain. It wasn't quite happening, and then it came through, so I shot out here. It's about a 900 meter hike through alpine terrain, quite dense bush. With all the gear anyway, it's quite tricky. So I'm just going to settle down now. I'm going to have a bit of a break. Been flat out for the last hour or so. What I am going to do is, I have two beverages here, and these are from Garage Project. These are called Happy Days, and these are a pale ale, 4.8%. I'll be having two of those tonight alongside my venison and lamb burgers. I've got the works tonight on this trip. I'm going to go place these in the stream. They're going to cool down. They're already pretty cold. We'll get my natural fridge going. Find a nice little shallow spot in the stream. Get these chilling for later.
That rain's starting again, slowly. So I'm just gonna have a quick snack. The Jack Link's beef steak bar. These are really good, full of flavor. Nice lightweight little snack, if I can get into it. There we go. Mmm, check that out. Mmm, these are so good. Mmm, they cost about $1 here in New Zealand. Mmm. So I've got a delicious dinner and breakfast on the menu for this trip. Venison and lamb burgers, tomato, eggs, onion, the works, burger sauce, sesame buns, and in the morning I think I'll make just a big omelette. Haven't done that proper cooking for a while with my camping. I've been using boil in the bag meals, heat and eats, just lightweight, simple. But I thought, nah, I'm gonna cook my dinner. I enjoy the cooking, and the alcohol stove is fun. So I get a lot of questions about animals and insects and spiders and stuff like that in the woods or in the forest, the bush we call it here in New Zealand. We don't really have anything that can harm us. We don't have snakes. We don't have wolves, we don't have bears. I think the most ferocious wild animal I could think of would be a pig or a possum. And possums are normally, they stay in their place unless you leave food out or something. Otherwise you don't get any trouble from them. But no, we only have a few spiders that can harm us. So the white-tailed spider, which is an Australian species, it came over in timber, I think back in the 70s or 80s. Anyway, that will give you a nasty rash. If you don't get treated, you can die. But it's not just going to bite you and you're going to drop and be paralyzed or die or whatever. So in saying that, we don't really have anything that can harm us. So I can quite comfortably just go out in the bush. I don't need weapons. A lot of Americans, you know, they'll take guns or bear spray or whatever. We don't need any of that here. It's pretty good. But, yeah, nothing to worry about in that way. So I hope that answers your question.
Alright, so I've just adjusted the tarp a little bit better. It's much better on this side now. That rain, I think it's coming across now. Should be here within 20 minutes, I would say, if the prediction's correct. But it does look a little murky up there. So I've lifted this up a bit. I've put some river stones under it just to jack it up a bit. That's just tensioned it all up, so. There's no wind tonight, it's like 3 knots all throughout the night and into the morning, so I'm not going to have a problem with the tarp blowing around. There's the seagulls. That means rain.
Right, so here's my little stove. So this is a Cedar Summit. You see that? It's a Cedar Summit Sigma pot in my alcohol cooker, which is like a Trangia style. Cheap man's Trangia. Actually fits inside. So, nice and compact kit. alcohol burner. I'll set this up.
Level ground. There we go. So I've just set up the alcohol stove. Haven't used it for a while. Chuck a big lump of butter in there to melt. Not too much, just enough. There we go.
All right, so as I mentioned earlier, venison and lamb hamburgers for dinner. Cheese, onion, tomato, an egg, and nice sesame seed buns. So here's the patties. Yes, they're store bought, I know. So there's two in there. Two will be plenty for me. They're gonna be nice, fat, juicy burgers. And then I'll be grabbing my beers out of my fridge, my stream down there, to have alongside this delicious burger. Now, I was talking, got this heating up. I was talking to Tony from AB Outdoors. I know if you watch his channel. So he lives down in the South Island of New Zealand. I'm in the North. And he actually tried these on a video. And he was telling me, separate the patties before I film the cooking. But no. And I'm already having difficulty, Tony. So should have taken up your advice. Yep, Tony was right. They're an absolute pain in the backside to separate, but I've managed to do it, so in they go. This is nice and hot. Listen to the sizzle. All right, in we go. Nice and hot, there's one. And two, let's give that a bit of a shape. Here we go, beautiful. Well, as you can probably tell everyone, it's getting a little darker. Still waiting on that rain. So I've got my venison and lamb patties sizzling away there. I'm sure you can hear that. Let me tilt this butter around. Yeah. They smell delicious. I cannot wait. So I've got these big cheddar cheese slices. So I'll put a couple of meat on each patty and they're going to melt over it. So I'll just about chuck them on now, I think. And yes, I did forget something. Onion. I left the onion at home or in the car. So no onion, but that's all good. Still got a bit of other stuff. Oh, that cheese smells good. Yum.
Yeah, look at that. Delicious.
This is going to be one of the best camping meals I think I've ever done.
Okay, I think it's starting to burn now. What I'll do is put that down there, lay on my bun. So I'm using Kelly's Kitchen Burger Sauce. Give you a zoom in at that.
Kelly's Kitchen Burger Sauce. Yeah.
Oh god, these are gonna be so good. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get the patties off the frying pan so they don't burn too much. I'll sit them on our buns. Let me put this out in front here. Should have brought my table. Should have brought the table. Oh well. Live and we learn. That's how we do it here. Rough. that egg will cook for the next few minutes. Ow! There we go. Whoa! I gotta show you this burger. Oh my god.
Alright, YouTube, are you ready?
Whoa!
Check that out. Venison and lamb, egg, tomato, sesame seed buns, and some of this stuff. Cully's Kitchen burger sauce. Look at that. I think that's one of the best camp meals I've ever done. But you can't knock it till you try it, so I better get it in me. Got that other egg sizzling there. Oh my god, this is going to explode. Oh. Mmm. Oh my god. That is fabulous. Let me get the light on that for you. Oh man. Mmm. That is pretty darn good. Oh, that cheese. Don't forget, our beers are in the fridge. Mmm. Happy days. Turn that down. You'll see that happy days from Garage Project. Exceptionally drinkable. Well, we shall find out. Cheers, everyone. Thank you for coming along on another camping in the rain adventure. Cheers. Garage Project, do not disappoint. What a way to wash down that delicious venison burger. That is good. Check out the artwork on the can. Not sure if you can see that. I'll turn this light off. Happy days, it's got a picture of a snowy mountain on there. Pretty cool artwork on the can, I thought. It's a palm tree or something. Mm. So I'm just burning off the rest of the alcohol fuel. There's not much in there, so I've got to just burn it off. That way it can't spill anywhere. It's a pretty efficient way of cooking the old alcohol fuel. That's just methylated spirits. So pretty cheap. It's off a bit of heat too if it was cold. As you can hear, nice shower just coming across, just real light drizzle. Still waiting for that heavy stuff. I'm going to save this beer, have it in about an hour or so. But it's just gone 7:30, so we're just starting to run out of light right now. Let's cook her up here. That dinner was beautiful. The best camp dinner I've done by far. Big fat juicy burgers, venison burgers. You can't beat that sound. The sound of the rain hitting the tarp just nice and lightly. So this is what we would refer to in New Zealand as spitting. Same thing as drizzle, I guess. Good people would say, it's spitting outside. It's real light rain, that's all it is. It's our Kiwi slang. You might be able to see it behind me. I'm not sure if the camera's picking it up or not. I don't think I'm projecting enough light back there. Well, as you can probably tell, it's a little bit darker now. I just put a fresh battery in the camera, went over some footage, put a new SD card in there to chew up the data when you're filming so much, especially in the new camera. All my previous trips were done solely on my phone's camera, so using this camera is a big step up for me. Cheers, everyone. Bugs. Oh. Oh. So this light I just received from a company from China. It's actually a really good light. As you can see, it's lighting up everything. It's got a built-in power bank, and I think it's 800 lumens. So if you know your lights and your head torches and stuff, it's pretty bright. So tonight's a test, so I'm just going to leave it on and see how long it lasts. So I put it on at 8:30. So see if it does the 2 hours on non-stop. So this farm's right on the west coast. So we get that extreme coastal weather. We've got wild surf beaches. If you've ever heard of the infamous Piha Beach from New Zealand, it's about 15 k's away from here. So it's a pretty rugged bit of coastline, and it's known for its own weather system. So that thunder will be offshore right now. Hopefully it comes here. We want the thunder and the heavy rain.
A little bit heavier now. Cheers everyone, camping in the rain. There's something about it that we find super addictive. I think all you guys and girls are more crazy about it than I am. So as I normally do, I'll dedicate the last sip of a beer to a YouTuber. So I think last time was Zeb, that was the first time. Zeb from Backcountry Kiwi. Actually, I've already done a collab with Zeb and Jesse. We went up into the Kai Mai Ranges in New Zealand, middle of the North Island. And we've done a bit of an overnighter up there. So this time, I'm going to shout out Tony. You know who you are, but I'll say it anyway. Tony from AB Outdoors, or AB Camping. Now I'm sure some of you watch Tony's stuff. Most of you will know Brucey, the Border Collie. Funny bloody dog, hell of a lot of attitude. But yeah, cheers Tony, thanks for some of the advice lately. And as a fellow Kiwi, getting out in the rain for our fellow subscribers. Cheers, man. This one's for you, this last sip. There's not much left. Oh, and if you don't know who AB Camping is, go and check out his channel after this video, because if you like rain camping and camping gear and dogs and camping, you're going to fall in love with his channel. So I think he's just clocked over 50,000 subscribers, 8 million views or something like that. So go check his channel out, he would appreciate that. And say you, and you can comment, Outdoors of CUS sent me here. Everyone, it's just gone 10:30. I'm gonna jump in the tent. There's a few possums up ahead, up top of me in the trees. I'm not sure if they're coming through the microphone or not. I'm gonna jump in the tent. I've got a book to read and I've got a podcast on my phone, so if the rain does get a bit heavier than what it is now, I will jump back out and try and catch some outside footage for sure. Oh, all right.
Oh, good morning, everyone. Well, it's not raining this morning, but there was some blimmin' heavy rain in the night. There was a big downpour about 11:30, and then again at about 2, from 2 till 4, just consistent heavy rain.
Good morning, everyone. I'm going to make myself a coffee to start the day. A flat white. Alright, so before I boil water, I want to cut with, so what I do is, just so I'm not wasting water, place it in there first. Before I boil it. Not that I need to be careful about the water I use, I've got plenty. It's just a trick I do. Sometimes I have limited water. Well, that was a really good night's sleep. I thought I was going to have trouble getting to sleep, but it was actually really good.
Do.
Cheers, everyone. So it's just gone 7 a.m. Sun's making its way through the trees and all the bird life is starting up.
Beautiful. I had the luxury of bringing my own milk today. Just a small carton. How many mils is that? 300 mils. So that would probably last me a few days if I was doing a two-nighter or a three-nighter. If I kept it cold enough. But it's just little cartons that we have here in New Zealand. And that cost about $1.30.
These look delicious. I'll try a corner.
Well, they're a little bit rough, but they taste delicious. Mmm. Mmm. So normally they would mix the eggs in a bowl or something like that. But yeah. I'm just doing it rough today, and it tastes fantastic. The onion, the flavours of the onions are all the way through the omelette. Mmm. Well, I just packed up my bedding and my cooking gear and it feels like it's going to rain. I can feel the pressure's just dropped, the temperature as well. We might get a bit of rain on the pack down on the way out. Just drying out my jacket. So this jacket is from Bushbuck Outdoors. This is rated for, I think, 10,000 mil hydrostatic head, waterproof. So it's fully seam sealed the whole way around the whole jacket. It's pretty well engineered jacket. I think they retail for around 399 or something.
Alright everyone, this wraps up this trip. It's come to the time where I have to end the filming and head on out. It's been a great trip, not as much rain as I would have hoped, but there still was quite a bit of heavy rain through the night. An awesome new spot, clearing in the bush. I'll definitely be back for some future adventures. So with that said, if you enjoyed the video, give it the thumbs up. It helps the video's growth, helps my channel a lot. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button for more adventures. And we'll see you on the next one. So until then, everyone stay safe, and we'll see you then. Cheers, everyone. See you later, everyone.